let the seats on down some.
We scoot over to the mic. I gotta scoot over. Are you okay, Mary?
I made it up.
Mama, can I see you?
Mm-hmm.
It's already down.
All right, we about to be live. Hey y'all, hey, it's your girl Siobhan Noel, and we live in the lab on Hits 92.3, the real definition of internet radio. Happy Sunday, everybody. Hope all is well. Hope you all had a great weekend and all that kind of good stuff. And we have Miss Mary in the lab tonight with our real estate segment. Mr. Deontay is on his way. Drive safely if you're tuning in. Good evening, Mr. Punch. How are you, sir? Thank you, Joy. We got a few topics we're going to hit on. Mary's going to bring us the business for real estate and all that kind of good stuff. And we're going to have a good time per usual. So I wanted to share a few things with you. But my question of the day today, or my icebreaker as I have been calling it, I want you all to tell me what you think about working for free concept. Hi, Miss Punch. How are you?
Good.
Tell me y'all's opinion about the working for free concept, also known as either sponsorships and or internship and externship. Now, I have done a lot of that, and I've also collaborated with other people on that. I feel like the younger generation is not feeling it at all. Mary, what are your thoughts on it? Have you experienced any of it, or do you do it? Do you offer it? Do you suggest it? What's your thoughts altogether?
Well, I feel like there's occasions when working for free benefits the person that they're working for.
And you can
for.
Pull the mic down a little bit. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So
it benefits the person that is needing someone to work with them or for them. For example, if you, like with my t-shirt brand, I try to get ambassadors.
Okay.
And when you have ambassadors, mm-hmm. you let them work for free because they're promoting your business. So it depends on what is needed and mm-hmm. what you're doing.
Okay, gotcha.
So it's not entirely bad to work for free. Oh, another thing is, you may want to shadow someone.
Yeah.
If you shadow someone, then you can work for free. You just want to learn what they know or the business.
Right.
So working for free, it just depends on what you're doing.
And I think that's a good point, because I think, especially when people ask for mentorship, guidance, or like, hey, I'm interested in doing what you're doing. Can you show me how, tell me how, introduce me to, et cetera? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I almost think that you should offer.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, is there something that I can do for you, you know, in exchange? Because we may not, especially just coming into it, you may not have the money to pay them for
exactly.
the, so at least offer, hey, can I come and, you know, file some stuff for you, do some, take some notes, whatever you need, in exchange for your expertise or for your mentorship and things like that. But I'm finding that a lot of young people aren't in for it, or they're not okay with it. Now, maybe a little bit more so on an internship where they're going to get credit for it, like
yeah.
for college
yeah.
and things like that. But I don't feel like they see the value in doing it. For the knowledge and for the connections.
That's true.
Yeah.
And another thing you could do is work for someone who's just starting a business and you all grow together.
Right.
So you can feed into each other. You might have some ideas that I didn't think of or
uh-huh.
whatever, you know, you grow together. But yeah, younger people now, they want something for it. You got to have something in it. You know, a free night at, or a free meal at Chick-fil-A or something. You
right.
gotta have something. And that's really not bad, because if you think about it, the age now that are coming up,
uh-huh.
they're they're really getting savvy about business.
Okay.
So they don't want to work for somebody for free because they feel like they're bringing something to the table.
Okay.
And that's another way to look at it. But, you know, if you're saying you want to get paid or you want to work with me and you bring something to the table, then you got to bring it.
Yeah, absolutely.
You got to bring it.
Absolutely, yeah.
Because, you know, this is an at-will state.
Yes.
At my will. Bye-bye.
Now,
but, you know.
I, back this past November, I provided, I was the media sponsor for, Clayton County's Chairman mm-hmm. Turner International Ball.
Mm-hmm.
So, it's similar to like the Mayor's Ball in Atlanta, but right. for a smaller scale for Clayton County.
Right.
So it's a black tie event, all the who's who there, elected officials, dignitaries, things
and
of that nature.
And she
was
looking beautiful. I saw her picture.
Oh, thank you. I was trying to be cute as a button, right?
I just had to throw that in there.
Paid gig, but I wanted to use that for an example because the exposure that I got from you was priceless as providing media coverage and things like that. And not only did I have the connections and the associations, but I was listed everywhere. Like they had
That's
Bonnie
awesome.
In the City plastered everywhere on the programs that everybody took home, on the signage everywhere it was announced. And so for me, the coverage was I would do it again, you
right,
know what I mean,
right.
for the exposure that I got. And so in a nutshell, it's to me is about finding boundaries, because you
mm-hmm.
do have to find boundaries, because I know everybody's like, oh, let's collaborate, let's work for free, and I'm like, wait a minute, well, we got to pay the bills too, you know. About finding balance. And at the end of the day, I always tell people, I liked I used this analogy I got from that movie, Why Did We Get Married, when Janet Jackson told the couples to write down your list of pros and write down your list of cons in your marriage. So I used that in the business world as well. In that situation where you're trying to see if you want to decide if you want to accept that sponsorship, quote unquote, or that collaboration, or that intern, externship, whatever it is, that exchange for service, write down the pros.
Right.
Then you write down your cons, because you have to see, what is it going to cost you and is it worth it? Because, you know, I had to buy a dress. I had to get my makeup done. I had to get my hair done.
Yeah.
I had to do things as well that I was going to pour into it. And so it's a lot of things you just have to decide. Is it worth it?
Right.
So go ahead. You look like you're about to say something.
I was just thinking when you were saying that. I don't know if anyone, I'm sure a lot of people have taken operation management, project management. So when you do project management, you set what you want to accomplish, but then in between, you put the roadblocks that might come up against you.
Right.
Right. With that instance, you know you're going to have to buy a dress, get makeup and all that. But at the end result is getting to where you want to be.
Absolutely.
So start the process with, what am I doing this for?
Your why.
Well, your why. Okay,
yes.
You know, I like to say that.
Yes.
Your why. And then once you know your why, then just sit down, like you're saying, the pros and cons.
Uh-huh.
What if I can't find a dress? What if I can't find the right shoes to go with the dress? So sit down and write down, kind of brainstorm.
Yeah.
How are you going to get to the end result?
Right.
And I think that helps a lot. But with the media coverage, I mean, you said it right. That's priceless. Because you would pay a lot of money to advertise on TV or to advertise on a radio show.
Mm-hmm.
Or, you know, some of these things are very...
Right.
So the exposure you got, I mean, that's just awesome.
Yeah.
Awesome. Yeah. I remember Lil Vonnie.
Aww.
Lil Vonnie at Remax. I was like, she was doing things unbelievable at that time, and she's still doing things. I'm
so
proud
thank you,
of
Mary.
You. I am.
Well, we are going to jump into our real estate segment.
Mm-hmm.
And tell me, did you have a topic tonight, or is it just candid convo type?
Well, I do have some things I need to, because there was a couple of times I was here, I said I need to check on that so I'm going to give some feedback to those things.
Okay, perfect.
Okay.
I'm going to let you do that. I'm going to go over there and get the punches all set up, Mr. and Mrs. Punch.
Okay.
And I'm going to let you take the mic for a few minutes. I ain't going nowhere.
Hey,
so. You just holler if you need a hand,
okay.
But you talk to the people, Mary. Tell them all about real estate.
All right.
Thank you,
okay,
dear.
Again, for those that don't know, I'm Mary Lane with the American Realty. I've been in real estate for over 15 years. I enjoy working with people. I did take a pause in between that, but it was for the good. So there was a question asked about what were some of the things that Biden was trying to implement as far as housing. There is a proposal in work, like a